6 greatest front wheel drive track cars you can buy on a budget. Let's take a look at some front wheel drive track cars that you can buy on a budget. If you haven't watched my previous videos, I'll link it down in the comment section. The previous generation of the cars in this list are also great front wheel drive cars. Before continuing with the video, smash the like button for the YouTube algorithm and a sub would be amazing. Honda Fit or Honda Jazz. The Honda Fit or Honda Jazz, depending on the region, might not have been Honda's best driver's car, but with a little work, it can be a great cheap track toy. You'll need to do a little digging to find one with a stick though. This iteration of the Honda Jazz was launched for the 2009 model year and facelifted for 2012 with a few minor mechanical upgrades. The launch years may differ depending on the regions. The new Jazz is powered by an upgraded 1.5-liter 4-cylinder iVTEC engine. In a move to deter true enthusiasts, a 5-speed automatic gearbox with optional paddle shifters was also offered. For 2012, the suspension has been retuned to ease the firm ride a bit, while retaining the tight handling. The speedometer features a large LED display providing of a broad range of information including current fuel economy and range indications. An integrated single CD stereo is fitted on all models, with MP3 or WMA capability and speed-independent volume adjustment. Features include 4 speakers, 2 tweeters and a USB adapter in the center console storage box. The Jazz is also equipped with latest version of Honda's Magic Seats in the back that can fold up or fold down in one motion. All models get power folding mirrors, air-cooled double glove box, keyless entry, alarm, 15-inch steel wheels with hubcaps and a front power windows. The EX trim adds a rear power windows, paddle shifters, 4 leather steering wheel with audio controls, 16-inch alloy wheels and cruise control. A panoramic sunroof and fog lamps are standard on the top version. The Jazz also comes in several bright colors. All Jazz models are equipped with ABS and electronic brake force distribution and dual front airbags as standard with optional side airbags. A redesigned version was released in 2014, but Honda didn't sell them in even more countries. Mazda 2. At first glance, the Mazda 2 seems like any other budget economy car. It's tiny with a small engine and it's built to fit in tight spaces. But club racers have taken the old Mazda 2's nimble chassis and made it a serious competitor. The 2016 2 is a new generation model. It is a hatchback and now uses its own Skyactiv chassis and engine. The Mazda 2 gets a 1.5-liter 4-cylinder engine mated to a new 6-speed automatic transmission. The front wheel drive Mazda 2 comes with standard features such as electric power steering, front discs and rear drum brakes, CD stereo, keyless entry, single zone AC and 14-inch steel wheels with hubcaps, LED headlights, fog lamps, leather seats, heads-up display, rear spoiler and 16-inch alloys are some of the optional features. Standard safety features include ABS with electronic brake force distribution and dual front airbags. The top spec model gets 6 airbags. Fiat 500. If you're looking to stand out among all the Honda and Ford hatches at your local track event, consider a 500 or 500 Abarth. It's light, sounds crazy, and drives wonderfully. Best of all, they've depreciated like crazy. Available only in select countries and dealers, the Fiat 500 is offered with only a 1.4-liter 4-cylinder engine with a 5-speed automatic and a front wheel drive. It comes in 3 trim levels, namely Pop, Lounge, and Sport. All trims come with standard keyless entry, trip computer, leather-trimmed steering wheel with stereo buttons, CD stereo, power windows and electric mirrors. In addition, the base Pop trim has a 15-inch alloy wheels and cloth upholstery. The mid-range Lounge trim additionally gets a sunroof, chrome exterior door handles, chrome exhaust tip, silver-trimmed side mirrors, Bluetooth, an upgraded stereo, front fog lights and 16-inch alloy wheels. The Sport trim adds automatic climate control and leather upholstery. An expensive Gucci hatchback model was introduced in 2011 with special trimmings. All models get front and side airbags, stability control and ABS. The convertible gets a cloth roof but does not fully open as the side window pillars are retained. The Fiat 500 was redesigned for 2020 but it looks all the more similar like before. You can watch the first impressions of the redesigned Fiat 500 by Matt Watson from CarWoW, which will be linked above. Volkswagen GTI. No matter what generation GTI you're into, you'll have the basis for a wonderfully capable track machine. Upgrade the brakes and tires and you'll be lapping your local track until you run out of gas. The Volkswagen GTI received a minor facelift for 2017, which included new bumpers, new LED headlights, new LED taillights and new wheels. It is available as a 5-door model and in some markets as a 3-door model. Under the hood, it is powered by a 4-cylinder 2-liter turbocharged engine and having a choice of 6-speed manual or 6-speed DSG auto-manual gearboxes depending on the region. It features a body kit with built-in rear diffuser and wider side sills. Compared to the regular Golf, the GTI also rides on 17-inch or 18-inch wheels with lower suspension. Inside it gets sportier seats, steering wheel and pedals than the standard Golf. Features include CD MP3 stereo, USB or AUX inputs, Bluetooth, multiple airbags, optional sunroof, smart keyless entry and start, common power accessories and more. Between the front seats, space is increased by virtue of a new electronic parking brake with auto hold feature. The Golf's steering now uses a variable ratio electric system and with optional park assist can parallel park the car automatically. It is also available with driver profile selection, which allows the driver to choose from several modes that alter the throttle mapping and engine management to their chosen style, such as Eco and Sport. For 2016, a limited edition 40th anniversary Club Sport variant was released with a more powerful engine and a revised body kit. Along with the DSG gearbox, a 6-speed manual transmission was offered later on for the Club Sport. Volkswagen GTI was also featured in 5 most tuner-friendly European cars you can own video and the top 10 best new performance cars under $50,000 videos, which will be linked down in the comment section. Ford Focus ST. The Ford Fiesta ST is also a great choice, but if the Fiesta is just a little too small for your needs or not available in your country, the Focus ST is also a great choice. It has 252 horsepower sent to the front wheels via a good old-fashioned 6-speed manual transmission. The Ford Focus ST got a facelift for its 2015 model year. Under the hood, like I said before, it comes with a turbocharged 2-liter 4-cylinder EcoBoost engine, mated to a 6-speed manual. Standard features include 4-wheel independent suspension, power windows, electric mirrors with indicators, keyless entry, CD stereo with USB or AUX port, capless fuel filler, 18-inch alloy wheels, keyless start, dual zone auto AC, rain sensing wipers, auto headlights, cruise control with speed limiter, Bluetooth, premium center console storage, fog lights and LED taillights. The Focus ST hatchback also gets a body kit, Recaro seats, sports suspension and an overboost feature for extra torque when needed. Standard safety features include front and side airbags as well as ABS, stability control with hill start assist and a torque vectoring system for better handling. It is one of my favorite cars that I've driven. A redesigned version was released for 2020, but Ford didn't release it in many more countries. It's a shame that Ford is going to focus more on SUVs in the future and not sedans or hatchbacks, as they did make some amazing cars. But the new Ford Bronco looks promising, so let's hope for the best. Mini Cooper. Minis have been popular budget racers since John Cooper began hot-rodding the tiny machines. They remain one of the most mile-inducing front-wheel drive cars on the market. Mini released an all-new Cooper and Cooper S hardtop model as a 2015 model. In 2017, the convertible joined the lineup. It is larger than its predecessor and features new engines as well. The new Mini looks quite similar to the old one. It is the same height but it is bigger overall, offering more interior space for its occupants. It is 114mm longer and 43mm wider than the previous model. In 2019, the Mini Cooper got a facelift and a new 7-speed automatic gearbox along with new features inside such as touchscreen with Apple CarPlay. It is a system similar to the BMW iDrive system. The Mini Cooper will be getting a twin turbocharged 1.5-liter 3-cylinder engine, while the Cooper S gets a twin turbocharged 2-liter 4-cylinder engine. They both can be had in either 6-speed manual or a 6-speed automatic transmission. Standard features include power steering, power windows, electric mirrors, keyless entry, central locking, fabric seats and alloy rims. Optional features include rain sensor, park distance control, comfort access, electrically operated glass roof, roof rails, electrically heated and folding exterior mirrors, interior and exterior mirrors with automatic anti-dazzle function, seat heating, two-zone automatic air conditioning, rear spoiler in John Cooper Works design, large selection of decorative roof and exterior mirror options, bonnet stripes, seat upholsteries, interior surfaces and color lines, mini navigation system, mini radio visual boost, and Harman Kardon hi-fi speaker system. Standard safety features include front and side airbags, ABS brakes, and stability control. Driver assistance systems package includes mini head-up display, driver assistant including camera-based active cruise control, collision and pedestrian warning with initial brake function, high beam assistant and road sign detection, parking assistant, rear view camera, etc. This list is not in any particular order and it all depends on your budget and interest. If you stuck around till the end, thanks a lot, it means a lot to me. If you enjoyed this video, I'll be doing a whole lot more videos like this in the future. So leave a thumbs up and a sub would be amazing. Also leave your thoughts down in the comment section. My name is Jitin and I'll catch you in the next one.